So far we've examined what are called local illumination models, where an object is affected by a light and the result is sent to the eye. Light comes only from, well, light sources. No light is reflected from other objects. There are many more light paths that can be tracked. One rendering technique that can simulate these is called ray tracing. We've seen how the GPU sends each object triangle in turn to the screen and rasterizes it. Ray tracing instead fires rays from the eye through each pixel. Objects are tested against each ray. The closest object found along a ray's path is the one that's used to compute the ray's color contribution. You can think of each ray from the eye as rendering a single 1x1 pixel. One way to find the closest object for this pixel is to send every triangle down the pipeline and attempt to rasterize it, using the Z-buffer to keep track of the closest object. This is perhaps the slowest way ever to perform ray tracing. In reality, researchers and practitioners have spent huge amounts of time creating and tuning algorithms to rapidly find this closest object along the ray. Where rasterization gets some of its speed is from the fact that a single triangle usually covers a bunch of pixels. Various intermediate results can then be shared when processing the triangle. At its simplest, ray tracing can give the same result as rasterization. Each ray from the eye finds the closest object along it. The effect of light on the surface is computed and the result is displayed. However, that's just the starting point for ray tracing. For the light-to-surface paths, we've made one obvious simplification for basic rasterization. Objects don't block other objects. In other words, no shadows are cast. In ray tracing, adding basic shadows is trivial. Shoot a ray from the surface to the light. If there's something in the way, the light is blocked and can be ignored. Since all computations happen in world space, we can avoid many of the precision problems found in rasterization techniques such as shadow mapping. Classical ray tracing also offers us the ability to create true reflections and glass effects. For shiny surfaces, we can spawn a new ray in the reflection direction. Whatever this ray hits is what is reflected in the surface and so can be factored into the ray's final color, its radiance. Let's say our sphere is actually glass. Instead of simple filtering, we can also spawn a refraction ray and see where it hits. When it encounters the other side of the sphere and exits, we spawn yet another refraction ray in the reflection ray. We can continue to spawn rays until we hit some limit.